Okay, so we're starting off on the 12th fret. On the D string, that's the very first note that we play. The next note is on the B string on the 15th fret, which is an octave higher. And we're playing a down with the right hand and then an up. The next note is with your middle finger, which is the A note, okay, and it's on the G on the 14th. So we have down, up, down, and then the 12th fret with the down again. We have down, up, down, down. Even if you just want to loop that one piece and go. The next notes is here, and you're going. We're playing the 15th. So we're playing between the 15th fret on the E to the 14th fret on the G, and we're playing an up, down, and the exact same thing, but this time just moving this note on the 15th fret down a fret. So even if you want to just loop that bit and go. So slowly this whole section. Now, basically, the picking pattern should not change too much. The next note that you change is between the D, and basically you play the note E this time here. But all the rest of the notes stay the same. It's just the very first note being D changes to E, and it goes. So, slowly. So you're going between this. This. Next note is the G. Play the exact same thing again, but just basically keep that as your kind of a main pivot note. So again. Then you go back to the D. So there's three main kind of what I call pivot notes. You have the note D, the note E on the same string, and then you have the note G on the 12th fret. So nice and slow. So for this very last section, it goes. Where your main pivot note is this note, which is on the G on the 14th fret, which is the note A. And this is your pivot note, which means that it's going to be basically the note that you always come back to. So you go. So you go between 12th fret, skip a string, come back to the G. So you go between the E, G. This time you go between the B and the G on the 15th fret. So then two notes. Back to E. 14 now on the E. 15. 14 again. 12. And then back to, which is your last note. So nice and slow. You're better off listening to it as opposed to anything else. So. If you want to loop that bit. So I'm going to play basically the whole lot and you'll hear how it goes together. So up to speed. D chord again, to a C chord, this chord you're playing the E note on the D string on the 2nd fret, middle fingers on the A on the 3rd fret, and your third finger is on the B string on the third fret. This is called a C add 9. That's your second chord. When you play over this, you play your G. And then you're back, then you resolve then back to the D. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this section starts off on the 11th fret, and if you imagine a kind of a D shape here, kind of going to the 9th fret, to the 10th fret in the B, to the 9th fret of the G. So imagine that shape, and you're going, then finish with, which is 10, 10, 9, 10, so slowly. Next section starts off, and there's a bit of a stretch on the 15th fret in the A to the 13th in the B, then G on the 12th, then the 10th, and then you have these notes, 12 on the E to 12 on the G, and then exact same idea but 10 on the E to 12 on the G. So you're better off just listening to this section. So again, I'll just go through that chord section again. You're going, back to D, repeat that whole section again. Instead of going back to the D and basically playing this, instead of doing that, you finish with this, which is the G going, sliding from 12 to 14, and then adding the B. So, nice and slow.